Welcome to part 3 of this video series on creating columns in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll demonstrate how to create and use these column types: hyperlink or picture, number, date and time, and calculated. Let's go to our Outer Banks ferry information list. We added these columns about the route in part 1 and these columns about the crew in part 2. Here, we'll create a final set of columns for manufacturer information. Click Quick Edit, then the plus sign to add a column for manufacturer. Click More Column Types to see the Create Column dialog. The name of the column is manufacturer, and the type of information is hyperlink or picture. Enter the description. We won't require content, and we do want the hyperlink format. Click OK. Click the plus sign to add the next column for knots and click More Column Types. Enter the name and select number as the column type. Enter the description. Let's choose to not require information or enforce unique values. The minimum and maximum speed values are 0 and 100. We want whole numbers for knots, so set the number of decimal places as 0. If there are any decimal entries, they'll be rounded. Leave the default value blank and skip displaying the number as a percentage. Click OK. Next, let's create the length column. Click the plus sign. Since this is a number column, let's try the number option. The column is created immediately with the default name of number. Rename it to length. While this is a very fast way to create a column, it does not allow you to configure any options as we did when we created the knots column. So this may or may not be the method you want to use. I'm going to edit this column because I want to complete the configuration. Click Stop Editing This List. Go to List Settings and click the Length column. Now we can add a description. We'll skip requiring information or enforcing unique values. Enter a minimum and maximum ferry length. If we let the number of decimal places be automatic, SharePoint uses the decimals as entered by the user. We'll leave the default blank and skip the percentage option. Click OK. We're on the Settings page now, so click Create Column to create a column for the date of last maintenance. Name the column. The column will contain a date, so select the type of information as date and time. Enter the description. We'll choose to not require information, not enforce unique values, use the date-only format, and use the standard display format. The standard display format is month, day, and year, separated by slashes. The friendly format, which is often used in social media, uses terms such as just now or 4 days ago. Leave the default value as none and make sure the column is added to the default view. Click OK. The last column is date of next maintenance. Click Create Column. Enter a name. We want the next maintenance to be scheduled 1 year after the last maintenance, so we should use a calculated column. And enter a description. The formula text box contains the calculation. Enter the equal symbol to start the formula. Double-click the last maintenance column to move it to the formula. Type plus 365 to add a year to the last maintenance date. Since we are working with date and time information, we'll select date and time as the output of the formula, then confirm we want date only. Make sure this column is added to the default view, then click OK. Let's go to our list and see our results. Here are the column types for hyperlink or picture, number, date and time, and calculated. Because it's a calculated column, next maintenance has a value, but it's meaningless without a last maintenance date. Now, let's edit the Hatter's ferry to add the manufacturer information. Select the ferry, then click the Items tab and Edit Item. Enter the web address and name of the manufacturer. Enter a max speed of 110, a length of 160, and a last maintenance date of 11/4/2014. We're not prompted for the next maintenance date because it's automatically created. Click Save. We get two error messages because we exceeded the maximum values we defined earlier for speed and length. Reduce the max speed to 88 and the length to 140. Click Save again and the record is saved. Note that the next maintenance date is 1 year after the last maintenance date. I'm going to move to a nearly identical list to demonstrate some usability tips. You can reduce the horizontal scrolling by creating several views with less information. For example, here's a view for ferry, for crew, and for manufacturer. Once other views are available, you can define one of those as the default, so the cumbersome All Items view does not appear automatically. In this video, we've reviewed how to create columns for Hyperlinker Picture, Number, Date and Time, and Calculated. Parts 1 and 2 of this video series review creation of other column types, and there are additional videos on site columns and on editing and validating columns. Two columns are reserved for use by web services: external data and managed metadata. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site and the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.